guys, Mark Smith, JBS Training Group.
Kind of want to make a quick video talking about offset dots on LPVOs again. I know that I've made a couple, but it keeps coming up, right? So we're gonna keep beating it until it isn't an issue anymore for some people. So one of the things that I'm regularly asked is, do I run my LPVOs? And in this video, understand, is, you know, talking about offset dots in conjunction with LVPO optics 1-6, 1-8, something with a 1x, right? And that's important to kind of touch on. That matters for what we're going to talk about. So do I run it at 1x? Do I run it at 3x? Do I run it at 6x? Like, what am I doing? Some people seem to be under the impression that the benefit of the offset dot is that I can run magnified for the LVPO and use the dot for, 1x stuff.
The problem with that is the
kind of the philosophy behind it, I think, in that you bought an LVPO, a 1X optic, because the 1X was important to you, right? Otherwise, you would have just bought something that starts at a magnified setting, such as a 3-18, 4-16, 2-10, whatever, right? But for whatever reason, the 1X was important to you. And I think if you were going to keep the optic at a magnified setting, I don't really know why you're using an LVPO. I don't know why you didn't just get a Mark 6 or a Mark 5 or something that starts at a magnified setting. I think that the offset dot for me, right, is there to supplement me with options for an aiming system, right? So I'm not just stuck with this. If the situation would be more beneficial for me, it would be more beneficial in the situation for me to use something else, right? Thinking about different angles, right? So the offset dot presents me with different angles to be able to manipulate different structures, barricades and things of that nature, different positional things. It provides me with a way to have a lower profile for shooting on, over, or around things sometimes, right? It is a passive aiming solution under NODs for dudes that don't like to use the VPO for the passive aaming or whatever. And the biggest one for me is it gives me the option to remove backup iron sights and replace them with a superior solution, a superior aiming solution, right? Dots will always be superior to the irons in terms of everything regarding shooting performance, right? So what I've done is I've relinquished their duty by replacing with something that does it better than they do. I don't think about an offset dot as a primary or a secondary sighting system, right? I think of it as an option. It is an option, the same way this DS00 switch on the back of my mod light is an option. I don't think of it as a backup in case my mod button goes down, I go to that. That is a plan that I have, right? But that don't make this a secondary. This is also a constant on, light source. It's also a strange positional, way to actuate. It's not a secondary. It's not, anywhere lower on the totem pole than the original. It's just an option. So I think that when we think about it like that, it becomes a lot more clear that, hey, this isn't something that we're just going to designate a duty for. This is just an option, right? And in our shooting, we will come up with things that this offset dot makes a little easier for us than just utilizing this. Now, obviously, there is the always, I'm dialed at 6, pew, 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 right, offset dot for something up close, 50 yards and in or whatever. But that, believe it or not, is kind of a rarity. I don't end up in many situations at all where I'm dialed and all of a sudden I got to switch to 1X. I think that has perpetuated the table too, where people think that's all that they're going to use it for, and that's why you should buy it. That's also not a thing for me. It's nice to have that option, right? That's what we're talking about, but that's not why I bought an offset dot. I bought an offset dot to have different options for an aiming solution for whatever situation the world may give me one day. So hopefully that kind of clears stuff up and gives you something to think about, right? It's a lot like red dots on pistols in that people really, I think, don't see the benefit of it until they've actually got some time behind it. And then, man, they don't want to let it go after that, right? Like, dudes that come from irons and go to red dots on pistols very, very rarely want to go back to irons on pistols after they've actually utilized the dot long enough to understand its benefits, right? I think the same thing can be said about offsets. in conjunction with LVPO, in conjunction with anything, man. It's just, it's a great tool to have that costs you around 3 ounces of weight to be able to supplement your entire package as the operator of this rifle to make you be able to do more efficiently in more situations. All right, so that's what I got on Offset Dots. Hope that gives you something to think about, man. Mark Smith, JBS Training Group, rock and roll.